Now let me solve problem number 1.51 for you. A rotating disc, there is a figure given like this. A rotating disc along XY plane moves in positive direction of x axis. This is moving in positive direction of x axis like this. Find equation yx describing the position of instantaneous axis of rotation. Yx is instantaneous axis of rotation. Now what is axis of rotation? Yx is instantaneous axis of rotation. Axis of rotation is locus of that point which remains stationary at the instant. Kisi bhi instant par locus of that point that remains stationary is termed as axis of rotation. The problem is based on this definition. If at initial moment the axis C of the disc were located at point O. Initially, yaha disc kahin idhar thi, point O par. After which it moved with part A pehle karta hu main. In part A, this is that it's moving with constant velocity. And with constant angular acceleration beta in counterclockwise direction, the initial angular velocity is taken to be 0. Now, let me solve this part A first. First of all, it started moving with constant velocity v, and initially angular velocity is 0 and beta is constant. So when beta is constant, angular velocity at any time would be beta into t. This is angular velocity at any time. Here this is the angular velocity. Now velocity v is constant. Velocity v is constant, hence x is equal to velocity into time. This is the location x comma 0. Now we'll say that instantaneous axis of rotation would definitely lie somewhere here on this axis. Why? Because on this axis, in this region, the velocity of this particle would be v in this direction, and due to rotation the angular velocity omega into y would be in this direction. This point P is having the coordinate of x comma y. Main kahunga at P which is x comma y, omega y is equal to beta t into y. Beta t is angular velocity and y is the radius. This is omega y. It's instantaneous axis of rotation if this velocity equal to omega y. Velocity, if it is equal to omega y, it's instantaneous axis of rotation. So I'll say velocity or velocity is equal to omega y ki jagah mein likhta hun beta t into y. And for time I'll say x by v. For time I'll say x by v. So I'll say this velocity or velocity is equal to beta y and for time x by v. Or I will say xy is equal to v square by beta. This is the equation for instantaneous axis of rotation. It's equation of hyperbola. This is instantaneous axis of rotation. The answer to part A. This is the equation for instantaneous axis of rotation. Dekhiye, humne kya kaha? Beta is constant. Beta constant is the angular velocity hogi beta t. Velocity is constant, then at any instant after time t, it would be located at x and that is equal to vt or t equal to x by v. Yaha point p axis of rotation kyun hoga? Kyunki is instant par translation ki wajah se iski velocity v positive direction mein aur rotation ki wajah se iski velocity omega y piche ki taraf. Aur yadi ye dono barabar ho jaye, p at point p this omega y is equal to beta t into y aur yaha point p instantaneous axis of rotation ho jayega yadi v equal to omega y. This velocity due to translation is equal to velocity of this particle due to rotation. Now this is the condition for instantaneous axis of rotation. Is condition ko apply kar diya, omega y ki value, phir time ki jagah time ki value aur hame equation mil gayi. Now part B, isi situation mein they says that this is y and this is x. This disk is initially at this point, after some time it's at this point. Now in part B they say that if constant acceleration w, yadi constant acceleration ho w, idhar bhi constant acceleration w, and zero initial velocity, initial velocity is zero, well velocity is zero at this point, some finite velocity, and disk rotate in counterclockwise with constant angular velocity. Now observe, if constant acceleration, if constant acceleration w, then velocity would be equal to w into t and x would be equal to half w into t square. This is x comma 0. Now due to rotation I'll say at any point here the velocity of particle is w or v, w into t, and due to rotation it's omega into y, where this point is p having x comma y. Observe, now I will say this w is constant acceleration, at this point p v is the velocity, या v हमें पता है w into t. Angular velocity is constant at p, I'll say at P, which is x comma y, its instantaneous axis of rotation if velocity at this point is equal to omega y. मैं यहां condition लिखूंगा. अब velocity की जगह पर omega into t लिखता हूं. Velocity की जगह पर omega into t. And see, this is angle, this is acceleration, this is w into t. मैं omega और t में किसी भी तरह से confused नहीं हो जाऊं, इसलिए क्यों ना मैं acceleration को तो a से ही denote कर देता हूं, ज्यादा अच्छा रहेगा. Acceleration को a से denote कर देता हूं, ज्यादा अच्छा रहेगा. So this becomes a into t. This is velocity is equal to omega into y. Omega into y. Now from here I will get t. T is equal to omega y by a, and I will substitute this value of t in this equation. X is equal to half of a into t square, omega y by a whole square, and I will get the equation for instantaneous axis of rotation as omega square by 2a into y square. This is the equation for instantaneous axis of rotation. This is equation for instantaneous axis of rotation, and observe that its equation of parabola, its equation of parabola in this case. In the second case, once again we have got constant acceleration and constant angular velocity. Constant angular velocity is counter clockwise action. Constant acceleration मैंने a लिख दिया है बस, वहाँ पर w और omega से बार बार confusion होता है. Constant acceleration a. Due to that constant acceleration, the velocity at any instant would be at, and constant acceleration is along x-axis. Initial velocity is zero, so displacement along x-axis is half at square. This is by first equation of kinematics at constant acceleration, and this is by second equation of kinematics at constant acceleration. S equal to ut plus half at square, this is equal to v equal to u plus at, इसे हमने लिख दिया. अब हम कहेंगे किसी भी इंस्टेंट पर यह पॉइंट पे एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन होएगा. कब? जब इसकी ट्रांसलेशन की वजह से वेलोसिटी इस डायरेक्शन में और रोटेशन की वजह से वेलोसिटी इस डायरेक्शन में. इसके अलावा और कोई सा भी पॉइंट इस डिस्क पर इंस्टेंटेनियस स्टेशनरी नहीं दिखेगा. ट्रांसलेशन की वजह से वेलोसिटी और रोटेशन की वजह से वेलोसिटी इक्वल अपोजिट होकर कैंसिल हो जा रही है, और यह पॉइंट इंस्टेंटेनियसली रेस्ट पर दिखता है. सो द इंस्टेंटेनियस एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन, दिस वेलोसिटी मस्ट बी इक्वल टू ओमेगा वाई. यह कंडीशन हमने लगा दी, वेलोसिटी की जगह at और ओमेगा वाई की जगह ऐसा कैसे. इससे हमने टाइम निकाल लिया, और इस टाइम को हमने इस इक्वेशन में सब्स्टिट्यूट कर दिया, x इक्वल टू हाफ at स्क्वायर, और हमें इंस्टेंटेनियस एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन के लिए एक इक्वेशन मिल गई x और y में. ऑब्जर्व द सॉल्यूशन, इट्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग प्रॉब्लम. एक बात आप और देखें, इस डिस्क पर जो किसी भी समय पर इस डायरेक्शन में v वेलोसिटी से ट्रांसलेट कर रही है, ओमेगा से रोटेट कर रही है, बाकी कोई सा भी पॉइंट यदि आप ले लोगे कहीं पर भी, तो इंस्टेंटेनियसली रेस्ट पर कोई सा भी पार्टिकल आपको कभी नहीं दिखेगा. इंस्टेंटेनियसली रेस्ट पर पार्टिकल पॉसिबल है तो वो सिर्फ और सिर्फ इसी एक्सिस पर संभव है. क्योंकि इस एक्सेस पर इंस्टेंटेनियसली ट्रांसलेशन की वजह से वेलोसिटी वी इस डायरेक्शन में और रोटेशन की वजह से वेलोसिटी ओमेगा वाई इस डायरेक्शन में पॉसिबल है। इसके अलावा और कोई सा भी पार्टिकल पूरी डिस्क पर कभी भी इंस्टेंटेनियसली रेस्ट पर नहीं दिखेगा। आप देखिए इधर ट्रांसलेशन की वजह से वेलोसिटी वी इस डायरेक्शन में और रोटेशन की वजह से ओमेगा वाई इस डायरेक्शन में, तो इनका रिजल्टेंट कभी जीरो हो ही नहीं सकता। इधर ट्रांसलेशन की वजह से वेलोसिटी वी इस डायरेक्शन में और रोटेशन की वजह से ओमेगा वाई इस डायरेक्शन में, रिजल्टेंट कभी जीरो हो ही नहीं सकता। तो सिर्फ और सिर्फ इसी एक्सेस पर ऐसा इंस्टेंटेनियस पॉइंट हो सकता, ऐसा एक पार्टिकल हो सकता है, ऐसा एक पॉइंट हो सकता है जो इंस्टेंटेनियस रेस्ट पर होगा। प्लीज नोट इट।